Good morning. This is Pastor Dustin coming to you on this Sunday morning, July the 17th. I hope you're doing well today. We are, at least for Fulton, we are online only this morning because I'm in isolation. I was tested positive for COVID a few days ago and doing much better now. Appreciate the prayers. Just dealing with, you know, some congestion, some of the lingering parts of it right now. And I know there's some others in the church who have been dealing with the COVID this week as well. So praying for all of those. As we come together this morning, we come together, you know, to worship God. And, you know, I'll do my best to sing a couple songs as long as my voice holds out. But then just have a few words from Scripture. And as we come together to worship our Lord and Savior this day in spirit, you know, we know we'd love to be present together this day, but we do the best we can. So, that in mind, I'd like to start out with just a simple come to worship song. Come now, the time to worship. Now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. Come, now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. Like I said, you will have to bear with me just a little bit. As long as my voice holds out here, it'll be all right. I do have my tea here. Try to see if keep my throat a little moistened up. But as we come together this day, we come together remembering all those who are suffering this day for whatever reason. This day, right now, you remember those who are suffering because of COVID still, is going around again. I know. Like I said, I've been in isolation now for a few days. But, you know, I've been feeling much better, but still have some of the congestion and stuff. I hope the, you know, others are as well. Did still want to share a word with you this morning. You know, I wanted us to be able to try to worship together. So, if you don't mind, just say a quick prayer that my voice will hold out while we do this and as we come to the Lord this day. You know, we remember, invite you to remember all those that you know of this morning who need a special prayer for whatever reason. And we'll lift them up as we go to the Lord together this day. Gracious and almighty God, Lord, although we are not worshiping together as we would like this morning, Lord, we come together in spirit Lord, and we just want to say thank you this day for all of your many blessings. Lord, for all of the ways that we know you are at work in this world and in our lives. Lord, we see you in the beauty that is all around us. Lord, right now, in the beauty of your creation. Lord, this beautiful sky behind me, the birds and all of those singing their songs right now. Lord, we thank you for the beauty of your creation and we get to enjoy it. And Lord, we also pray this day for all those who are struggling for whatever reason, for those who are struggling because of illness. Lord, we pray for healing. Lord, for those who are struggling for other reasons. Lord, whether it be emotional or spiritual or financial, Lord, those who are grieving, Lord, whatever it might be, Lord, we just pray for you to bring healing in whatever way it may be needed. Lord, let your spirit move, Lord, in each life, in each situation, Lord. Lord, let them know that they are not alone, that they are not forgotten and not forsaken, that you are right there with them, Lord. And Lord, as we come together around your word this morning, Lord, just let your word be spoken. Lord, let everything said and done be for your glory. Lord, help us to always stay in your will and in your care. Lord, we lift these things in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. All right. And it's time, I'd like to share one more song with you this morning. And said, I know several of you know it, so join along, and hopefully I won't cough too much doing it. Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me, and like a flood, His mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace. The Lord has promised good to me, His word my hope secures. He will my ship and portion me as long as life endures. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. Like a flood, His mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me, and like a flood, His mercy reigns. Unending love, amazing grace. Earth shall soon dissolve like snow, the sun from there to shine, but God who called me here below will be forever mine, will be forever mine. You are forever mine. Amen. We'll get there. Okay. Now I wanted to share with you some scripture out of Isaiah, chapter 43, starting in the first verse. And I know, last few weeks I've been preaching from Ephesians chapter 6, been preaching on putting on the full armor of God, and been talking about spiritual warfare, getting ready, prepping to go into battle. Because I really do believe that it's time for the church to stand up and go into battle in this world. Yeah, as I've said, you know, there's so much that is going on in the world around us that's not right. For the sake of our families, for the sake of our communities, it is time for the church to stand up, be the church that we've been called to be. It's time for us to stand on the Word of God, to stand up and go to battle. I mean, the devil is certainly doing his job. He's been coming against us, trying to come against the church, trying to silence our voice. But he will not win. He has already been defeated. I believe that even some of this right now, the timing of, you know, the being in isolation, these things, there's a lot of good things that are going on right now, and I really do believe there's a reason for the timing of this, but we are definitely locked in spiritual battle right now, and it is time for us to take up the full armor of God that we can so that we can stand against the wiles of the devil. And I'm telling you right now, he's trying to come against my voice, but I ain't gonna let him. God is stronger. Oh. Whew. We need to take up the whole armor of God so that we can stand in this evil day. Stand firm in the Holy Spirit. And stand firm in prayer. Oh, with all the pieces of the armor, with the with the belt of truth. Our loins girded up with truth of God. With the breastplate of righteousness to protect our heart, to keep us right with God. Our feet shod with the gospel of peace, the helmet of salvation, the shield. And the sword of the Spirit. But even in the midst of all this, I believe that God, the reason why we're facing so much spiritual warfare right now, I really believe is because We are about to see a revival like we have not seen before in our day. We are about to see a revival that it, and like anything we can imagine. Oh, God is moving in this world. And so Satan is trying to come against him. Satan's afraid of what God is doing. And so we can trust in that. You know, and I am thinking about that. I wanted to share with you from Isaiah 43. Starting in the first verse. But now thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob. Do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt as your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in exchange for you, because you are precious in my sight, and honored, and I love you. I give people in return for you, nations in exchange for your life. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east, and from the west I will gather you. I will say to the north, give them up, to the south, do not withhold. Bring my sons from far away and my daughters from the ends of the earth. Everyone who is called by name, who I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. Bring forth the people who are blind yet have eyes, who are deaf yet have ears. Let all the nations gather together, let the peoples assemble. Who among them declared this and foretold to us the former things? Let them bring their witnesses to justify them. And let them hear and say, it is true. You are my witnesses, says the Lord, and my servant whom I have chosen, so that you may know and believe me, and understand that I am he. Before me no God was formed, nor shall there be any after me. I am the Lord, and besides me there is no Savior. I declared and saved and proclaimed when there was no strange God among you, and you are my witnesses, says the Lord. I am God, and also henceforth I am He. There is no one who can deliver from my hand. I work, and who can hinder it? Thus says the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. For your sake I will send to Babylon and break down all the bars, and the shouting of the Chaldeans will be turned to lamentation. I am the Lord, your Holy One, the Creator of Israel, your King. Thus says the Lord, who makes a way in the sea, a path in the mighty waters, who brings out chariot and horse, army and warrior. They lie down and cannot rise. They are extinguished, quenched like a wick. Do not remember the former things or consider the things of old. I am about to do a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. The wild animals will honor me, the jackals and the ostriches. For I give water in the wilderness, rivers in the desert, to give drink to my chosen people. The people whom I formed for myself, so that they might declare my praise. This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. Oh, there's so much good in this passage here from Isaiah 43. God himself said, you know, over and over said, it is I who formed you, I who made you, I love you, I have redeemed you, I have called you by name, you are mine. Those are the words of our Lord, the one who is above all. And even he said, before him there is no other God, there is no other God like him. He said, I am the Lord. I am he. There is no one who can deliver from my hand. I work, and who can hinder it? And then he goes on to say that he is about to do a new thing. He says, can you not perceive it? The world that we are living in today is a world in much need of God's grace, of God's Holy Spirit, of God's power. We need to be praying for a fresh outpouring of the Holy Spirit on the church, on our world, and on us personally. So we can be a part of this great revival, this great awakening that is coming. God is doing a new thing. He's about to make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. So I will give water in the wilderness, rivers in the desert, to give drink to my chosen people, the people who I formed for myself, so they might declare my praise. We are God's people. Church, it is time for us to stand up to declare God's praise in the midst of persecution, in the midst of trials, in the midst of spiritual battle. We can praise our hands and praise God and say that we know he has the victory. Even while we are still on the ground, while we are still in the midst of the battle, we can raise our hands and say, God is the victor. And I am going to trust in him. I am going to praise him. God is moving. And I believe this with all my heart, church, that God is moving in a very special way in our day. And we can either let him use us and be a part of, or we can be left behind. But God is moving. And God is calling us to be a part of this spiritual battle. That we go into battle knowing who has the victory. And we can face everything that we face day to day knowing who has the victory. It's all God. And when we go through illnesses, when we go through hard times, when we face persecution, trials, whatever it is, we can face it knowing who has the victory. Ooh. Our God is an awesome God. Oh. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns, oh, forever and ever. And he is moving in this day. Oh, and he's wanting to use us, church. I've been preaching about getting on, taking up the armor, going in a spiritual battle. And it's time. And the devil, I think, is seeing what God is trying to do. And he don't like it. in our churches, even in my churches, Fulton and Shady Grove, God is moving. God is moving. And when God gets to moving, the devil not gonna like it. But we go into battle knowing who has the victory. Jesus won the victory on the cross and in his resurrection. We know we're not doing this alone. And we take up the armor and the strength of the Holy Spirit by his grace. We go into battle knowing he's with us. We go into battle knowing he has the victory. Praise God. God's doing a new thing. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness, says the Lord, and rivers in the desert. He said, to give drink to my chosen people, the people whom I formed for myself, so that they might declare my praise. Church, this day let us rise and give God praise. Even in the midst of our trials, in the midst of our struggles, in the midst of the things that we're dealing with in this world, knowing that God has the victory, right now knowing that God is doing a new thing, and we can trust in him. Amen. Ooh. Let's pray. Gracious Lord, Lord, even right now, Lord, I know that my voice may be trying to fail on me. But Lord, in the midst of all our trials, in the midst of our struggles, Lord, we know that you are here. We know that you have the victory. Lord, even while we're still in the midst of the spiritual battle, we've got our armor on. We're going to the battle in this world, Lord. We know without a doubt that you have the victory. Because you had a victory, Lord, we do. Lord, we don't battle from a place of defeat, a place of weakness. We battle from victory through your Holy Spirit. Lord, give us your strength. Lord, just help us to open ourselves up to your Holy Spirit this day and every day, Lord, to see what the new thing that you're doing, to be able to grasp the victory that we have through you, Lord, even as we go into spiritual battle in this world. Lord, we know this isn't the end. Lord, we know that you are here. And Lord, we know you have the victory. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We praise you. We love you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, church. This day we go forth to serve our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to go forth in the battle with him, but knowing he has the victory. The same one who created all this beauty all around me out here. The same one who created you and me and called us by name. He knows us, he loves us, and he has given us the victory through Christ. Amen. Amen.